Good morning, everyone. This is M4J, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to be talking about the most rare and the most beautiful thing in the game. But before we get into that, I do want to say it has been a bit of time since I've posted something. I had not had the chance to make a video lately, but I will be having a Loza Sherman review out soon, as well as the TVP VTU vid. Again, coming out fairly soon, maybe next week or so, and hopefully the Loza Sherman will be able to come out this weekend. But I've been trying to do those, but I have not really had much of the time. But today we're going to be watching the Cheeto SPG here in Mad Games. As you can see, it has the speed boost, and it likes to rock around quite a lot in this, which is going to be quite hilarious when those new physics come out, which will make it possible for the tank to tip over. Using this in Mad Games is not going to be very fun whenever that happens. But, so what is the most rare and the most beautiful thing about World of Tanks Blitz? And that is teamwork. Even the smallest bit of teamwork we are going to be seeing in this battle is just absolutely marvelous. So, talking about this replay here, as you can see, there goes our KV-2. We had 3 heavy tanks over at the city. Now we only have 2 heavy tanks, and the enemy's entire team is at base A. So there goes the AR-L-44, only leaving our one remaining KV-2. He's about to be taken out fairly quickly. Our P-43 Biss, it looks like he is deciding to make some sort of heroic charge into the middle of the enemy team. I have no idea exactly what he is thinking. But my Cheeto SPG, I'm going to be pushing up onto this position and trying to get a couple of shots off. We fire that blind shot on the KV-2, and as a matter of fact, it actually did hit the KV-2. So we're already up to maybe 300 damage or so. We see the KV-2 again. I'm just gonna wait for him, waiting to be spotted, and again we go for another blind shot, and again that one did hit. So our Smasher, he manages to get a shot into the Lupus here, and there goes our P-43 Biss. So now it's a 3-7. A 3-7. All three of the guys, me, this Bulldog, and the Smasher, we're all full health. So as long as we do teamwork, we might be able to win this, but it's not going to be easy at all. We have one base captured, so the enemy team's gonna have to come to us. And this is a really good thing. Even if they capture base B, there's still that base C, and it's just 3-7, yeah, they're kind of expecting to be winning this. So their Smasher, first off, is a bit of a noob, because he's shooting armor-piercing at the not very well-known Cheeto SPG, which has fantastic armor. So right away, we managed to bounce 640 damage. I'm just poking around every 5 seconds or so with the adrenaline, snapshotting these 300 damage rounds into the Smasher and the ARL, able to penetrate them no problem whatsoever. So the ARL, he's starting to rush here, put around into his track. He decided to sit there and aim for a bit. Quite a bit of a mistake, in my opinion. So I'm sitting here trying to bait his shot. I'm going to poke around. We shut him down. And it's now, thanks to my Smasher on my team, shutting down the Dicker Max, and the AR-L-44, or the Lupus, sorry, it is now a 3-4. So we've brought it down to more manageable terms. I've already racked up around 2,000 damage or so. Our Bulldog, he is fairly healthy at the moment. Unfortunately, he does take a nasty shot from the enemy KV-2. For some reason, the KV-2 did not shoot armor-piercing at the Bulldog. Maybe he didn't have a full view. But either way, he still shot armor-piercing. Bulldog's one shot now, not dead, so that is good for us. So our Bulldog, he puts the Irradiator on the KV-2, which made me really happy, which meant I could take him out with my next shot, guaranteed, as long as it penetrated. So our Smasher's in trouble. I'm going to get over there as fast as I can using this speed boost. As you can see, I can't really control the tank very well with the speed. Our Smasher's about to die. I need to get over here. I need to help him out. I want to see if I can get a couple rounds on this Yak Panther 4. Being a bit greedy there, I completely missed that shot. I see our Smasher, or the enemy Smasher, appear on my right, so I'm going to turn, and I'm going to start focusing on him, ignoring this Yak Panzer 4. So I'm sitting here. I need to bounce a shot from him. I should be able to take one from him, and we do just that. We managed to bounce another armor-piercing round from him. The Bulldog, again, puts the Irradiator on the Smasher, so we're able to do 500 damage, and the Bulldog is able to shut him down. Now it only leaves this Yak Panzer 4. Hopefully I can take him out. Not quite. Only leave him at 10 health, and our Bulldog, I'm just going to let the Bulldog take the kill. So while that was a very small amount of teamwork on the Bulldog's part and on the Smasher's part, All three of us, together with a plan, managed to hold off 7 tanks. And I do have to say, big shout out to that Smasher and to the Bulldog, because while the Bulldog didn't do that much damage, he still managed to put that Irridator on the enemy team, and we were able to shut them down a lot quicker. So that's 4,000 damage for my Cheeto SPG, 3,600 damage to the Smasher, Deadshot, and for Quad Meme 42 in the Bulldog, a fairly decent game helping us out take down this 3-7 win. So I just wanted to show that quick replay to you guys. Really, really easy game. And honestly, I didn't have much teamwork on my side. It was kind of more of one stand kind of thing, except when the Bulldog put the Irridator on. But that very little bit of teamwork is just absolutely amazing when it happens, because nowadays it is so rare with the toxicity of these players. But when you do get that rare moment, whenever your team will coordinate with you to help you take down an amazing battle like that, it is just the most rare and most beautiful thing in the game, and one of the reasons why I like World of Tanks so much. But this is M4J. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and we are over and out.